What's up, everybody, and welcome to the very 24th episode of Locked from the Other Side, where a group of friends come together to discuss all the nerdy news you can shake a stick at. I am one of your hosts, Eric Borgon, and I'm here. Gio Pimentel's here.
That was all in one breath. Here I am.
Mike Amaral's here.
Yep.
Tom Silva's here.
And it's the Copa America Centenario preview episode. I'm excited.
Wait, we don't do sports.
Yep, we're doing it today.
We do sports like literally every episode.
No, we just
then we focus on it more when someone says that we don't.
No, we don't do sports. But Euro is coming up really soon.
I hate the RMV.
Oh. Well, yeah, you did mention that.
I was there all fucking day.
Were you going to murder someone?
I was pretty close.
Pretty close? Were you there?
How long were you there?
Four and a half hours.
Can we ask why you were there for?
Shit.
4.5 hours. Renewing my license.
All that. He couldn't do it online, huh? You had to,
like, no. Because I had to switch it over and get a new picture and shit because it's like.
Yeah, it turns your license from vertical to horizontal.
Like an adult.
They can fucking blow me.
Wow.
Four and a half hours.
There's like no real good time to go.
What time did you get there?
Half hour after they opened.
Wow.
That's probably the worst time.
That's a half
if
hour
you go on
late.
Wednesdays, I think Wednesdays.
No, if you
is the
go
day
right
go.
When they open, there's a line outside.
I drove by.
There was a line outside.
Yeah, I think that's the worst time to go is right when they open. I did it on
a Wednesday once and I walked down in a half hour.
I wish.
There you go, Wednesday.
Well, what happened was they flew through everybody. But then they just stopped calling. You know how it's a letter and a number?
Oh, yeah.
So they did like fucking 10 I's in a row. I had I. And then it's like, I'm sitting there, and like, an hour goes by.
J.
An hour and a half goes by.
Z22.
2 hours go by. I'm like, they haven't called a single fucking I. I was next. Motherfucker.
It's like in Beetlejuice where he has like the longest number in the world, and he switches it with the headhunter.
I've never seen Beetlejuice.
Oh, man.
What?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, neither have I. That's lost in me.
It's good. It's good.
I've heard.
Yeah, I just missed that window.
Okay.
That's a great
when
movie.
It came out to... Now.
To now? That's a big window.
He sure got a jamboree down at Universal Studios, though. I'll tell you that.
Does he really?
Yeah, I've walked by it a bunch.
Didn't they get rid of that, though?
It was there last time I was there, which was last year.
Oh.
So, no.
I don't know the last time
Not
I've
yet.
Been to Universal.
I don't know if I've ever been to Universal.
Well, let me tell you. Butterbeer ice cream. Moving on.
Butterbeer ice cream.
Name of this episode.
Butterbeer ice cream.
We can't just say that for every comment someone makes.
Seems like that's the
well,
way.
Well, it's topical because of those Harry Potter and the Cursed Child photos with Black Hermione came out.
I don't care. I'm curious about the play. I don't care that it's a Black Hermione.
No, I don't care about the play. The book's coming out, so who cares?
The play's just a script.
It's fine.
Yeah,
that's fine.
That's your things, not my things.
That's fine. I don't need to see the play ever. Didn't care about the
You'll
Black
go
Hermione.
See it.
I'm not going to go see it. It's sold out. It's in London.
It's in the West End.
It's too foggy anyways. You wouldn't be able to land.
You'd be circling around forever.
You might end up in France again because of a volcano.
No, France was because they booked too small of a plane. Shout out Air France.
Minor.
Never forget, you jerks.
It's an oversight. Possibly.
Who wants to go first this week?
You know, I'll go first just to kind of let it set in.
What's your favorite ice cream?
What the fuck does that mean?
No, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to preview my topic and then we'll discuss it later. Okay, just to give you guys time to think. Okay, what it is pet peeves that really shouldn't be pet peeves.
People making me wait for stuff. That's serious. I hate when people do that. Like I told Tim this the other day, our friend Tim the other day. I hate when someone's like, basically what you're doing, but someone's like, oh man, I have something to tell you at 1 o'clock and it's like 10 a.m. I'm like, fuck you, just say it now. I don't care what it is. It's enough to want to wait.
Well, what if it's really important, but it's only important at 1?
I don't care then.
You don't care. All right.
I live in the fucking present, not in the future, not in the past.
Well, that's what I wanted to discuss. Mine is, because I already obviously have a reason for saying this, is I was at a drive-thru, right? And the person in front of me, there were two people in front of me, but the person directly in front of me was like a mile away from that person. So there was like a big ass space and it bothers me that they don't pull up all the way. That just bothers me too. I like get angry. I want to shout out the window, start throwing shit at them.
I feel that way.
And it really shouldn't.
Lights.
It's not
just
a big
to close
fucking,
the gap.
It's not a big fucking deal, but it bothers me
Use
that much.
Use all available space.
I get so angry.
I get like that with like traffic on the highway. Like if someone stops so suddenly and they have so much room ahead of them, I want to get out and kill them.
Well, that's just dangerous. That happened to me today.
I want to kill him. Like, why are you stopping so short and you have so much room? They think they're going to like hit the person in front of them, so they give themselves like 80 feet.
80.
Did they pull far away from the window?
That's another thing. When they're picking up their shit, they're like, they have to open up their door. Like, I don't... And
let me tell you, when I used to work at McDonald's many moons ago, nothing cracked me up more than that when the door would open and I would just look at this massive gap. And now when you're standing at that window, it's like you might as well be diving into a pool from like 40 feet up, because it's just like, wow, that's quite the distance. And I got to lean over this. And then they're just like basically standing up to reach to you.
They might as well
like,
at that point,
it's not that difficult to like drive next to the window.
No, it's not very hard at all.
Or close the gap.
Close the fucking gap. Seriously. Anyways, that was. I just wanted to discuss that a little bit. You've already displayed your emotions with me trying to wait a little bit. Not even to one.
It was literally just a pet peeve of me. I hate when people like. I got to tell you something later, motherfucker. Say it now.
You're just impatient.
It's not even impatient. It's just stupid because it's never anything that's actually important.
Well, the reason why I want to do it is just to give you time to think about something.
No, I wasn't specifically. I mean, I did it as a joke to pick on you, but that is an actual pet peeve. I do not like when people do that.
Do you guys want to come at me later?
If I think of something, I'll let you
come at me, bro.
No, I'll tie it back around to what I was saying about Black Hermione there. That so
black people. That's his pet peeve. You heard it here first. See you next week.
So that whole thing came up and people freaked out about it, and I was like, who cares, it's a play, whatever. And then it was J.K. Rowling who came out and was like, oh well, you could infer it, that's, you know, that's what I intended when I first wrote them. No you didn't,
it's bullshit.
Just people who bullshit like that, shut the fuck up.
She did the same thing just with Dumbledore being gay.
With the Dumbledore being gay, it just, she's one who's a prime example of it. But I hate when people do that. Just fucking own it. She should just come out and be like, who gives a fuck that she's black? Fine, get over it. She was the best actress for it.
Yeah.
Just right. Say
whoever's
that.
Most qualified.
Don't be like, oh, well, you can infer from what I wrote. No. The one black character in the book, you said that he was black. Hermione, you said she had bushy hair. If you want me to infer anything else from that, that's fine then.
Right.
Because she's Asian. Then, or don't approve book covers that have her displayed as a white person if you wanted people to not think of her a certain way. Like, just shut up.
Own up.
Just own up to it and just say that she was the most qualified and best person for the job, and that's why she got it.
You could say that with, like you said, with anything. Like, yeah. People in their hirings, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
You know, just hire the best person for,
it's simple.
For what you want
to
do.
I have to deal with that stuff, like, all the time for, like, work. It's like,
really?
You have to hire, like, every ethnic group, no matter who is best qualified for the position. Like, if we're doing a casting call and this actor kills it, but he's not this specific demographic. Like,
but you already have like, that we you need. Already had like one Asian person, so you can't have a second Asian person.
Yeah, and it's just it's retarded because it's like this guy was better than this guy, but we need to pick the second guy because he hits the ethnicity that we need for that specific spot or commercial or whatever. Yeah. It's just terrible. It's stupid.
That's all I'm gonna say. People who bullshit like that is my pet peeve.
Okay. I originally had a different topic. It was about Tetris being a movie.
I thought you were gonna say ice cream again.
In Japan. Like possible like
Pixels 2.
It's a trilogy.
Yeah, it's gonna be a trilogy, which makes absolutely no sense. How can you come out with such a shit bum of a movie of Tetris? Like, I don't even understand. It's supposed to be like some action sci-fi movie.
That's the greatest game of all time.
It's supposed to be an action sci-fi movie about Tetris.
Yeah, you explained to me how to contain the story of Tetris into one movie. You tell me that, and I'll tell you why they shouldn't make three.
But how can you even come out with like something like that?
Come up with a story at all.
You're going to have three fucking
movies. They're making 10 Avatar movies, so there you go.
They won't even make an Avatar 2.
One can only hope.
I hope they don't.
The movie sucked.
Disney's also going to come around.
Which is weird.
We haven't been building Avatar Land in Animal Kingdom.
That movie made so much money. It's the highest grossing movie ever.
It's no one terrible.
Can you find one person that likes it?
Or that knows
James Cameron?
Or that knows that it's the highest grossing movie of all time?
I think most people know that.
People are like, really?
You would think there'd be there were other movies that were higher grossing than Avatar. I would think.
I really thought Force Awakens was going to do it. I was like, this is it.
I thought this
is the moment.
I think it made more globally, but not domestically.
What, Avatar?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think you're right. All right,
maybe that's...
It's global poll.
Yeah, it's global. Exactly.
At this point, I'll take a Transformers movie getting over it.
It's never... Nothing
it's,
nerdy...
It's because people flipped out when that movie came out. Yeah. And it was like, oh my God, this is going to be the greatest thing of all time. I didn't even go watch it.
I like James Cameron for his other stuff, like with his like...
Yeah, like Alien and...
Yeah.
Terminator 2.
Yes.
Terminator 2. Yeah.
I mean, he's made great movies, but Avatar just terrible. Fell asleep.
It's not terrible.
It's pretty bad.
It's pretty bad.
It's Pocahontas with blue aliens.
Yeah.
It's not. I don't mind it. I don't mind it.
And it's long. It is so boring and long and stupid and pointless, and I hate it.
It's no Lord of the Rings.
Yeah.
Speaking of long and boring.
if you're going to want me to watch, you want me to watch a 4-hour movie, I got to have some dorks.
You won't do it? Not going to.
I honestly don't care what it is. I will not watch a 4-hour movie.
Yeah.
Lord of the Rings is 4 hours.
You know what? Stephen King has 4 hours.
Return of the King is. Return of the King is.
But that's my least favorite one.
4-hour movies, but they're more like almost like a mini series.
Yeah, they're also, yeah, they're broken up.
Yeah, they're a little different.
Yeah.
What?
Stephen King and his, they're made like TV movies or whatever. But anyways.
How did we even get on Avatar?
That was me
pet
talking
peeves.
About Tetris.
Oh, Tetris. Tetris. Yeah, okay.
Pet peeves, Avatar.
Yeah.
James Cameron movies.
But he also does like shipwreck diving and stuff.
Yeah,
like
that's so stupid and boring. Oh my God.
I like that stuff.
What is it?
So dumb.
What's so boring about it?
Didn't he do a bunch of that for Titanic?
Yeah,
he's obsessed with it.
Yeah.
He did a lot of stuff with
it. It's what he spends all his millions upon millions upon millions.
Meanwhile, his ex-wife is just winning Oscars left and right.
Who is his ex-wife?
Catherine Bigelow.
Oh, right, yeah.
Hurt Locker, Zero Dark Thirty.
I watched Hurt Locker yesterday. It was good. I like that movie.
It's the first time you watch Hurt Locker?
No.
Oh, okay.
It was on today, too.
Yeah, it's been on.
Yeah, it's a good movie.
No, I'm not going to say it.
You don't like it?
I don't want to.
Of course.
I don't like either of her movies, really. I don't think Dark Thirty is that great, either.
You turn it to me?
I haven't seen Zero Dark Thirty.
It's not as good as Hurt Locker, because it's not, you know, there's not a lot going on. Because it's all...
Yeah, it's more like back
rooms. Yeah,
I think
the ending
of Hurt Locker is great, but like the whole movie to me doesn't do anything.
Yeah, it's good. I
want to see Sicario. I heard that was good.
Yeah, I've been saying that. Still haven't watched it yet.
Me too.
You know what I just saw a preview for its broadcast premiere? Sabotage, the Schwarzenegger movie. Great, great movie.
Oh, Sabotage is an excellent movie.
Me and Tom Wayne saw that in theaters. It was awesome.
It's cute.
Got Joe Manganiello in it.
Joe Manganiello, Arnold...
That's really all you need to know.
And Arnold.
And the chick from The Killing.
With the main chick?
Yeah, yeah. The detective.
What did
there.
I watch recently that was freaking awesome? Oh, Interstellar. Have you guys seen that?
Yeah.
Dude.
I have not seen that yet.
Talking about long movies.
It's on my...
movie's long good. As fuck.
It's not that long. It's like 2.5 hours.
It feels long. It feels longer
it does
than
get it, yeah, it does get to a point where it's like, holy crap, this
is
kind of long, but
it could end,
it's good.
It's one of those movies like where Batman versus Superman where like... At the end, yeah, it feels like it could end like 4 times.
Like the Return of the King. We end the suffering, please.
Just end this fucking movie. Yeah, I mean, but just end it.
Yeah. Return of the King had to cut out the good stuff, like when they had to save the Shire. So missed out on some real good stuff there. Could have kept going, because let me tell you, when they return to the Shire, it is fucked up.
Yeah, but they didn't.
They didn't. They should have had that part.
It could have been a 5-hour movie. It should have been 2 movies, but...
I would have been the only one in the theater watching it.
It's terrible. Terrible.
Who's got a next topic?
I like The Hobbit.
I haven't watched The Hobbit.
I like The Hobbit movies more than I like Lord of the Rings.
Yeah. There's supposedly better books as well, I guess.
No.
Well, it's only one book.
Yeah, that's right. It is one
book.
Yeah,
the book's not that much better. Book's okay.
Whatever, I don't read.
Exactly.
I don't do that reading stuff.
You'll never know.
Which gives you more detail on every tree branch?
The Hobbit gives just as much detail as Lord of the Rings does. Yeah, so that's
I read like the first chapter and I'm like, oh, I can't. It's so dense.
Yeah.
It's like, I'm not saying he's a bad writer. He's obviously a great writer, but to me, like my reading thing, it's just so dense.
When I was in like junior high, I tried reading that and it was not happening.
You can't read either.
Yes, I can.
So I can read.
I just don't.
Wasn't that a grade book like for younger kids?
Yeah,
a book
The Hobbit.
Book?
Yeah. The Hobbit's supposed to be a kid book.
It was pretty
tough. Are we all stupid?
No, it's
hard.
It's his writing style.
He does like so much detail and you're like, what is he even...
Describe.
Oh, I just saw this sign. I'm supposed to ask you if you're recording.
Yeah.
You're recording. Full disclosure, Mike deleted one of our episodes.
You won't get audio in the last episode.
No, video. Up. Video, right?
No. You get video.
Well, he didn't record the lost movie podcast, the movie, Mike's Movie Madness.
Yeah.
It was a great one, too. I mean, honestly, it's probably the best episode we'll ever do.
And you'll never see it.
You'll never see it.
Yeah. That one's gone. General consensus, we liked Captain America.
What's your topic, Mike?
Okay, hold on.
How to not delete everything.
I have to shoot a wedding.
Be better. Skate better.
Skate better.
Skate better. Okay, Brie Larson, maybe Marvel's Captain Marvel.
Marvel, yep.
Variety broke the story. Larson is apparently Marvel's top choice for the role of Carol Danvers, Captain Marvel. Keep on saying, wanting to say Captain America. She's in talks, blah, 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 blah. And they're saying that she is probably going to be used in either Black Panther or Guardians of the Galaxy to introduce her.
Probably Guardians of the Galaxy, right?
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
But that should be wrapping up filming pretty soon. I don't care.
But Infinity War.
I mean, I'm with you. I thought I was going to be the asshole who said it. I don't give a shit.
I like Brie Larson. That's why.
I'm not talking about Brie Larson. I'm talking about Captain Marvel.
Oh.
I'm talking about superhero movies in general.
I feel like they've been hyping that one up. I was like,
I'm excited
for it. Who's
going
to play her? Who's going to play her?
Like for 5 years now.
Yeah.
I mean, no, I don't even think I'll go see that movie in theaters. I'll see her when she's in Guardians because I'll go see Guardians in theaters. Mm-hmm. But Captain Marvel, I don't really know anything about her other than she's from space and she's like a colonel.
She's from what?
Spice.
I don't think she's actually even from space either.
No, she's not. She's a colonel in the Air Force, I think.
I don't even know her backstory. That's why I'm going to go watch the movie.
Who gives a fuck?
I just like Allison Brie.
Yeah, I don't know anything.
Okay, are we talking about Allison Brie or Brie Larson?
Wait,
I mean Brie Larson.
I like Allison Brie too.
I like Allison.
I don't know what that has.
I like both of them. She was good in Room.
Okay, I was just gonna ask you if she was the one who was in Room.
Yeah, she won the Academy last year.
She was coat check girl in Community.
Oh yeah, okay.
The one season that Dan Harmon was around for.
Okay.
She's in Scott Pilgrim.
Yeah. Didn't see that.
Great movie.
I did. I don't like it.
I like it. I like that movie. Who is she in Scott Pilgrim?
She's the ex-girlfriend.
Oh.
I don't remember her name. But the one that he's always like afraid of.
Yeah. I don't know anything about
Captain Marvel.
Captain Marvel.
What's her name? I don't even know her name.
No, I don't know
Captain
much about
Captain and then the company.
Oh.
Yeah, gotcha. There you go.
I gotcha.
There you go. Basically, Superwoman, Supergirl, essentially, right? Is that?
Yeah. Is that the
I got the gist
equivalent?
Of that, right?
I know, mixed with
like a Green Lantern.
I know that.
Yeah.
I know that Rogue got like all her like superpower from her. That's all I know about Captain Marvel.
Rogue from X-Men?
Yeah. The reason she can fly and has super strength and stuff is because she sapped her powers for too long and she like got them permanently.
Oh.
Don't ask me why I know that, because Rogue sucks and so does Gambit. So they both suck my dick.
Did you see X-Men?
You know how pumped I was for X-Men? You know how pumped I was for that movie? Haven't seen it. Probably won't see it in theaters.
Yeah, I don't think I'm going to go see it.
I feel the same way.
I'm at the point with superhero movies where I'm like, just if I could watch them at home, I would. To go out to a theater for them, I just don't want to anymore.
I'm more excited to go see Popstar.
That actually looks okay.
Well, it's like, and I still
want to
see.
It looks hilarious. Say it for me one time.
No.
And I still want to see World of Warcraft, so it's like I'd rather see those than this X-Men movie, especially when everything coming out was like, it's meh. It's a movie.
But you're going to see Warcraft.
Stuff happens. Exactly. I haven't seen World of Warcraft yet. I've seen X-Men. I have better X-Men movies that I own that I can watch.
No.
Wait, you saw X-Men?
No.
Oh, okay.
No, World of Warcraft, is that?
It's just Warcraft.
It's just Warcraft.
Oh, yeah, okay. You're messing me up. Stop it. I'm old.
Whatever. You know what I meant.
How'd that do for, like, critic-wise? Is it
Warcraft?
Getting trashed, really? Yeah.
Fans like it.
It looked okay. Like, from what I saw in the trailer.
Critics are critics, and fans like it, so it's like, yeah.
Huh. Because I was hopeful for that to be, like, the best video game to movie.
You're going to have to wait for Assassin's Creed.
Yeah, no, you're going to have to wait for one. The Division.
That movie won't happen.
With Jake Gyllenhaal. That movie's never coming. That game's barely out.
Nah, I know, right?
It would probably actually make a better movie than a game, but
the game was fine.
Well, you still playing it?
No, because I'm playing Uncharted and now The Last of Us Remastered.
Well, you didn't play it. How long you played Division for?
I maxed out the level and was waiting for the expansion.
already?
Yeah. Well, no. Well,
when's the expansion? It's not coming out for a while.
It already came out.
Oh, it did?
Well, the excursions.
Oh, all right. Like the raids or whatever?
Yeah, but then Uncharted came out, so I didn't. Yeah.
I don't know.
Remember that time Tom Hardy was signed on for a Splinter Cell movie 8 years ago? And an Uncharted movie's been in development for 10?
Splinter Cell. That was a game once.
And it hasn't
been out in a long time.
The Last of Us is apparently a movie, too.
Well, Uncharted is like a freaking movie in itself. I mean...
Yeah, I don't need to see an Uncharted movie.
Right.
The Last of Us would have been
it's
a cool
Indiana
movie.
It's Indiana Jones.
Nah.
Mm-hmm.
Not really.
Mm-hmm.
Not really.
Feels like it.
I can get that movie fix from Indiana Jones for it.
Yeah, I think
and
so.
And then play the games. Have
it's
a good time.
What they went for, you know?
No, I know it's what they went for, but there's a clear difference.
Yeah, obviously. Harrison Ford's not in Uncharted.
No, I mean, one's an archaeologist.
A wannabe archaeologist. Thief.
Nope.
And not Harrison Ford.
I like how that was your sticking point that you were going to go
Harrison
to.
Ford's not in it.
Harrison Ford's not in it, obviously. Yeah, Nathan Drake doesn't talk like...
You just went into your Stallone.
definitely didn't. But anyway.
Tom, what's your topic?
Are we going to me?
Yeah.
Yeah, what you got?
DC Rebirth. Am I the only one who read it?
Yes. All I know is they're restarting a bunch of shit.
It was like that issue that Jeff Johns wrote was really good. Because the whole thing was like there's like speculation stuff that he's like taking shots at Zack Snyder and like Watchmen and stuff because of talking about how like all the joy's gone from the DC universe and how it's gotten basically been dark since Watchmen came out forever ago. Everyone had to go dark and gritty. And like the whole thing is that 10 years of their lives were stolen. And that's why New 52 happened. And like everyone reverted to like, you know, like Batman was like a couple years into being Batman. And like it's because of the 10 years were stolen. At least that's what the narrator of the comic, who's Wally West, is telling you.
And adult Wally West or black Wally West?
Adult Wally West.
Okay.
Adult Flashpoint Wally West, who... is like the whole thing is him trying to come back. He's stuck in the Speed Force and he's blasting and he's telling you everything that's happening. So like he tries to come back to Batman and ends up, and eventually he ends up coming back. So Wally West is like back. Barry's able to, he goes to Barry and Barry remembers who he is and pulls him out of the Speed Force.
Hmm.
So now there's the black Wally West who they're related. They're cousins or something.
Whatever. I don't works for me. Comics.
Is the first issue
way,
called Rebirth?
Huh?
Is the first issue called Rebirth or is it like a...
That's like the reset issue is Rebirth and now like the actual
everyone's
Rebirth
own stuff is
going to
come out.
Okay. Like Batman just came out and Batman was just more of a continuation of the Snyder Batman.
Who's writing it now?
Tom King, who wrote Grayson.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, so like the whole new main villain kind of thing, the theory... No, not even a theory.
It's pretty much confirmed. Yeah.
Dr. Manhattan's the one who stole the 10 years.
Oh, okay.
Dr. Manhattan's the one who did this like wipeout. And so like it's brought the Watchmen into the DC universe now. Like Batman's like, I don't even know if he's in the Batcave or he's somewhere in the Rebirth issue. And he pulls out the comedian's button from like out of a wall. And then I've heard things about like the Question is actually Rorschach. So they're kind of like, doing a whole thing with that now. So I'm assuming...
Wait, they're not keeping the continuity of Watchmen either?
I guess somehow Watchmen's going to work its way into this universe. I don't know
how, Rorschach dies at the end of Watchmen. Spoilers.
Right. Right. So that's why I'm like...
Yeah, that confuses me.
That's why that confused me. Comedian... Dr. Manhattan, I felt like you could just involve Dr. Manhattan without even involving the Watchmen.
Yeah, because it also... He's so powerful that he could just go to another universe.
Be like transdimensional.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, so it doesn't really... I feel like you really don't need to involve any of the Watchmen. Not to mention...
Rorschach's basically Batman anyway, so like there's no point in...
I like the Watchmen comic.
Yeah.
On its own.
But I don't really care to have it involved in the DC universe. I read Watchmen. It was great. Done.
Yeah.
But like, I think if it's just Dr. Manhattan that's involved, I think that's actually a really cool idea.
Because that would make sense.
Because you can believe that Dr. Manhattan can wipe out a chunk of time. Yeah. Believe as much as you can in comics-wise. So
Dr. Manhattan might be like the only like person that actually could like fight Superman too.
Pretty much. Yeah.
And you actually would believe that Superman would lose.
Right, because it's like, how can you not? He's essentially God.
Yeah.
He goes off to Mars because he's sad.
We should do something like that, like a top 10.
Go to Mars?
No.
Elon Musk wants somewhere to be there.
No, just like a top 10 superheroes, like from the, like, the, who's like the supreme to.
Oh, like.
You mean like power-wise? The bracket show that I've been doing, wanting to do forever?
Yeah, let's do something like that.
Like power-wise?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. But anyway, so that's, I don't know if you guys had read anything else about Rebirth other than that.
I knew about that part. I didn't read it, but I knew about that because it leaked like 2 days before it came out or something.
Yeah.
Like,
I mean, I picked it up. I went to go pick up comics. It was like $3 and it was 80 pages or something.
Wow, $3. That's a
shock. So I was like, that's a $3 comic. That's rare.
Did you read that issue with Captain America? Being Hydra.
I didn't. I just.
Yeah, what?
All I care about is that has created, like, the greatest memes ever. Oh, where, like, Batman, I killed my parents. Spider-Man, fuck responsibility.
Oh, and, like, just, like, one last thing about Rebirth before we go talk about Captain America. Now that's just lazy. The Batman. So, the only one I've read other than Rebirth is Batman. But, like, it looks like it's getting, like, pretty good reviews otherwise from all the other ones that have come out, because Green Arrow came out, Green Lanterns came out.
I actually heard Green Arrow is the best one.
Green Arrow, yeah. Out of all Green Arrow is getting really good. I might actually pick that up because it reunites Green Arrow and Black Canary, because I guess I didn't even notice that they didn't know each other at all. No,
because fuck the show.
Because.
Just saying.
Flash comes out next week, so I'm going to pick that one up, especially now that Wally's involved. And Wally's actually going to be in Titans. There's two different Titans comics, Teen Titans and Titans. Teen Titans is led by Damian Wayne.
That's cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And then Titans is Nightwing, right?
Because
he's back to being Nightwing, correct?
He's back to being Nightwing, but I'm not sure if it's him.
I think he is.
I looked at the cover and I forgot who was on the cover. Now Captain America. It's just so lazy.
Yeah.
It's just...
I don't know anything. I don't read...
It's setting up a whole twist, and then it's going to be like, oh, he's just Steve. It was something implanted in his brain. He's never been Hydra. It's just like, oh, God.
Or he's like just pretending to...
Yeah, like I don't want to...
Like Black Widow.
I heard the comic, like, in general was good. Like, the new writer is, like, really good, and the comic itself is really good. But just that twist, it's like, I don't want to read a story arc about that.
A lot of people are pissed.
Yeah, but that's comic fans. People are pissed about it. They know...
That's nerds.
Though, yeah, even though they know it's not going to last, it could like last like... I still don't think it's as bad as the Otto Octavius.
I was just going to say that. I was just going to say
Peter Parker.
Well, that's Max Landis, I think, has like a video or something, or it was a tweet where he's like... People complaining about Captain America being a Nazi. No, he was literally been a Nazi for one page of one issue.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, people are trying to act like he was a Nazi all through World War II.
Yeah, exactly. And that's just why I don't want to read that story arc. I know it's something new and interesting and exciting, and it's like kind of a sales thing, but I do not give a flying fuck.
Isn't there like three Captain Americas now, though?
There's just two.
Bucky's not Captain America
Bucky's
anymore.
Been Winter Soldier.
Okay.
And then it's Captain America. So
Falcon, right?
I guess actual Captain America is Sam Wilson.
Falcon. Okay.
In terms of who is like
the official
Captain America is Sam Wilson. And then Steve Rogers
is Fuhrer Hydra.
Apparently that. Like, I don't know what they're gonna do next, nor do I really care. Like wanna make me uninterested. Once I saw that twist, I was like, you know what? I'm gonna read it. I don't care about the spoiler. And I read it and I was like, oh, good. I'm glad I read this. I'm not going to buy this comic. It was also like a $5 comic. Wow. So
I'm all for anything that makes quality memes. In a world where 90% of memes now are trash, I'm all for quality.
There's been
memes.
Some funny memes out of that.
They're all great. All the memes out of that are so great. There was a Sonic one.
It said, gotta go slow. And Tails is tied up in the cockpit.
Quality memes all the time.
I'll just put a crying Jordan face on it.
Actually, that one.
Poor Jordan.
Just make one with Steph Curry that says, I hate threes.
Because I did this one the other day, Gio. If I, you know.
Oh, jeez.
Since everyone can see that one, but, you know, they'll tweet it out maybe. Probably not.
You know nothing, Jordan Snow.
Oh, God. Eric, do you want to do your topic?
Yeah, I guess I could go. I didn't know if we were still talking about Captain America.
No, and Nazis. I'm all set with that. That's
Captain America.
So my topic is, as I said, I've been playing Uncharted. I beat Uncharted 4. Then I went back and I played Uncharted 1 through 3 again. Then I played Uncharted 4 again. And now I'm playing Last of Us.
God, I wish I had your time.
They're 6-hour games.
I know. I just wish I had time. That's all.
Don't have children, you stupid idiot.
No. I would never take them away. Don't take them away.
I'm not saying take them away now that they're here. I'm just saying you should have never had them.
No.
Anyway, my question to the panel. Is Naughty Dog the greatest studio of all time? I'm going to read you some Metacritic scores. Starting with Uncharted Drake's Fortune, 88. Uncharted 2, 96. Uncharted 3, 92. Uncharted 4, 93. We go back to Jack and Daxter. Jack and Daxter 1, 90. Jack 2, 87. Jack 3, 84. Let's go back to Crash Bandicoot 3, 91. Last of Us, 95. They didn't have Crash 2 and 1. Is there a more prolific game studio that pumps out more quality of games? Like, it's unheard of, the track record that Naughty Dog has.
They do ride the wave, though. They put out a great... They have something really good. Say, for example, Uncharted.
They usually have one. Uncharted's the only one that's crossed generations.
Right, but what I'm saying is they have a great mindset where they have Uncharted and they complete it, and they do it well. Mm-hmm. They didn't really... What I mean is they don't have many other titles other than those, what is that, 3, 4? It's essentially the same thing.
Oh, I mean, we could go further back to their older titles. Like, they do have older titles.
Do they?
Yeah, Crash isn't their first game, but...
Yeah, they have older titles and stuff like that we could go back to, but, like, that'd be... These... That's just sticking with them more.
Yeah.
What people are going to know.
Do they have any...
Well, first of all, I guess we got to think of studios that are even...
Comparable.
Putting up, quality games like that. So, like, the first one I thought of was Insomniac.
Yep.
I also don't think Insomniac's at Naughty Dog's level.
No. I don't even think it's close. But, like, when's the last time you heard someone talk about Sunset Overdrive? Like,
I'm me telling Gio about it today, but like I was telling Gio, it's like, you know, it's a Ratchet and Clank game.
Yeah,
it's not as good as the Ratchet and Clank games.
But like, think about like,
and then I guess if you count Nintendo as just a developer,
just gonna say, yeah, like Nintendo.
You have to count Nintendo as a developer.
But look at them now, like
right? No, right. But like, I'm not like going for the comparison of saying like who's better. Well, I'm just trying to think of like the what you can establish as studios.
Do they have any piles of shit though? Like literally, like do they have any games that are
Nintendo?
That didn't do well at all? No. Naughty Dog.
No, that's the thing.
They don't have any games really.
They don't.
I just don't know. I'll have to look it up.
I mean, I don't know off the top
I would
of my
definitely
head,
consider
like,
Nintendo
the games
though.
Before like Crash, how they did. But if you start at Crash and work your way up, they don't have it in any game other than remasters that are ports that other studios did of their games that score below an 80 on Metacritic. An 85. Well, oh, there's 184.
Right.
And that's tough on Metacritic stuff.
Yeah, that's the critic Metacritic because, you know, you're a mixed bag of shit with user score.
Yeah.
Yeah, it looks like they hit their stride with Crash.
Prior to this, they also developed games including Dream Zone, Keef the Thief, Rings of Power, and Way of the Warrior.
Which is nothing like
But they partnered with Insomniac. They partnered with Sucker Punch, Ready at Dawn.
I'm trying to think of other video game developers.
Ready at Dawn was Golden Abyss, wasn't it? Bethesda's not. I get throwing it out, but it's like
Daxter.
I mean, you may not. Their Metacritics have been pretty high as well. What am I doing? I mean, Nintendo does have their bags of shit games, but they also have their good games too. I mean, have you thought of any other ones other than Naughty Dog being at the top?
I really can't think. Like, that's why I brought it up. I can't think of a studio that produces quality A-plus games every time. Like, you can throw in Nintendo, but what's the last, like, great Nintendo game?
Yeah, well, Nintendo's in trouble now, but yeah. I mean, considering their...
Well, any studio, you could go back to the past, though, is what I'm saying. I'm talking, like, in the here and now for the last 20 years.
20 years, yeah. Oh, yeah, because Crash Bandicoot.
Yeah, for the last 20 years, they haven't made a game that hasn't been greatly received. Not even well received, greatly received.
I mean, 38 Studios put out one game and it was awesome and then that was it. So, I mean, you can count that, right? No, because
they're in bankruptcy and Kurt Schilling can never show his face in the state of Rhode Island.
It actually was a good game.
Wait, hey, good for
it
him.
It was
though.
A good game.
Yeah, it actually was.
Who wants to go to Rhode Island?
All of us sitting here.
Shit. Son of a bitch.
Shit, we are in Rhode Island. Blizzard.
Yeah, but they've only made expansions to a game?
Yeah.
They make a couple games
Starcraft.
And then a shit ton of expansions.
Yeah, that's...
They have a lot of RTS.
There's a different model.
It's like StarCraft, Warcraft.
Definitely, I would consider
Diablo.
Those more niche than the Uncharted, Jack and Daxter games. Those have a broader appeal.
Yeah.
There's like Konami, Capcom... I'm just trying to name
wait,
developers.
Hang on. Speaking of Konami.
We're on just complete opposite sides of the spectrum.
Let's derail this for a quick second. Gio, did you see the Metal Gear Solid Pachinko machine?
No.
What
are they doing?
Yeah, that's a thing. That happened.
Of course it's a thing.
Yeah, it happened.
Well, it's not.
There was a trailer for it.
They're finally going to calm it down on Metal Gear games.
Metal Gear Solid Snake Eater Pachinko machine.
Stupid.
Why would they calm down on Metal Gear games when the last one is... considered like the best one.
Wait until they want to make a movie.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, if we're gonna go in the 20-year range, going back to Crash,
I mean, you
three.
Got Capcom,
yeah,
no. Mega Man, Resident Evil, Street Fighter, Devil May Cry, Dead Rising, Monster Hunter, Lost Planet.
Even those after a certain point are well received.
Resident Evil sucking.
Yeah,
Mega Man. They don't make real Mega Man games anymore. They don't even
make Mega Man Legends.
What happened to Mighty Number 9? Is that ever gonna come?
That's
out?
That's coming out.
Watching the screen.
It was a really bad.
Check out this dash attack.
So stupid.
You didn't see those bad trailers?
Yeah, that trailer was so dumb.
It's a game I totally get from my Vita. Oh, wait a minute. It's not coming to Vita because they're liars.
Lies. Yeah, I'm trying, man.
It's tough.
That's what I mean.
It's tough.
Naughty Dog made a lot of good games in the past 20 years.
Because I would say definitely Insomniac's.
They're all considered really good.
Exactly. With what they've put out. And it's probably because of the time span between games that they could only put out X amount of games.
Yeah, I only bring it up because like they don't miss. Like they haven't had a swing and a miss. They jumped from Crash Bandicoot, a platformer, to Jack and Daxter, a mixture of a shooter platformer.
Well, they went Crash Bandicoot, that was Warped in Time, great for those motorcycle levels, to Precursor's Legacy, which is basically platformer,
but then they switched
to Jack 2, which turns into Grand Theft Auto, and Jack 3, which is now like, which same thing, is still an action
and they're
game.
Now they've done it across four generations.
Yeah.
Like, when you think of PS1, Crash is the game you think of. Arguably PS2, Ratchet and Clank and
Jack and Daxter
are
the
games.
PS2.
Three, Uncharted dominated the thing.
It was the
and Last of Us at the end.
Apparently, according to Wikipedia, Nintendo was formed in 1889. Just so you know. 1889. So they've been doing it forever.
They have. No, that's no. True. Yeah, we're not.
Back then, Animal Crossing was literally like you just farmed with animals.
That's it.
No, that's Harvest Moon.
It was real.
That was Harvest Moon.
Yeah, the only other thing, the only other developer is really Nintendo, only because of Zelda.
Nintendo, you got Microsoft. They make.
But even Microsoft's a publisher. Microsoft Studios, right, is a publisher. Because that's why.
Yeah, they don't.
I didn't want to say Bethesda at first because I don't know the names of the studios. Bethesda, Fallout. Is it
Bethesda? Bethesda's a developer.
Is it Game Studios?
Yeah.
There's Obsidian right there.
They made that. That was my argument against Bethesda, though. Like, the best Fallout game in the past 10 years was Obsidian, not them.
Right.
Arguably, I know people can argue.
Yeah, no,
that,
I mean, it's one or the other. It doesn't matter. Man. Yeah.
I still keep looking at 4 like I'm going to play it. I just can't bring myself
to
play it.
I put it in my Xbox because
and then you played Far Harbor.
And then you played Witcher.
Everyone's shitting over Far Harbor.
Really?
Because it makes you go into like a first-person puzzle game right in the middle, and you have to do it in the middle of like...
What the fuck's the point of that?
Exactly. That's people's problem. Like, you take me completely out of the game, and then I don't want to play the rest of
it's
it.
It's tough.
It's never been a...
That was like the freaking casino add-on.
That one was just hard, though.
That was freaking... They could take away all your weapons and shit, and that was sucked.
It's tough with RPGs, though, to go back to them anyway. Like, I haven't bought The Witcher... Blood and Wine because I'm like, I gotta get in the mindset of going back into
I gotta get both
The
of
Witcher
DLCs.
And it's like I wanna play it really bad, but I haven't played The Witcher since last fall.
I'm gonna get over
when I beat it.
All the games are basically the same.
And they take the amount of Grand Theft Autos that they put out in the same time as Jack and Daxter.
I forgot about them.
Yeah. Ooh.
Rockstar. You could count Rock. I would probably put Rockstar up there with them. I would definitely, if not like
I'd
second,
put that,
tied
put,
with
yeah,
them because
I'd,
they've not only like same thing, not only Grand Theft Auto, but they put out like Bully.
Well, they had Midnight Club. Manhunt.
Manhunt got banned.
Yeah.
What in Australia
and Red Dead?
No, they got banned like in a lot of places.
Yeah,
Red Dead was
pretty much everywhere.
Everything gets banned in Australia.
Which is funny because they're the country that brings us Mad Max.
You know,
right?
Square does very well, not necessarily here, but in Japan.
Yeah, but they've made really crappy games
over the past.
They
have made a lot of crappy games.
Yeah, they've missed a lot. They'll go big gaps with like hitting on something really good. Because
the only reason I would put Rockstar 2 and not quite on the level is because... they're not as prolific. Like, they're great. Their games are the same quality, but it takes them 10 years to make.
Well, I think they do it by choice.
No, that's what I'm not saying.
Very different games. Very different. Where, you know, with Rockstar, that's it's more of an MMO. Like, people are still playing that, and that came out a long time ago.
Yeah.
With Uncharted, you can replay it, but you're going to get generally the same experience.
I was thinking about that. Mm-hmm. 5 came out, 3 years ago,
right?
You know?
And people are
almost
still
3 years
playing
ago.
GTA.
Yeah.
There's a big community like playing that, trying
to
find
it took
all
them
the
2 years to play the online mode. Anyway,
that was
that's
that,
what I mean. Like, they fucked that up. Their stories are not nearly on the level of a story that Naughty Dog would produce.
Yeah.
GTA 5 story was pretty good. I liked it, but anyways, Ubisoft maybe.
No,
I think 4 had a better story.
Ubisoft.
I like Nico's story better.
Yeah, I like their stories. I don't mind.
Actually, I could have done without Trevor.
Nah, he's the only one
I
like.
Yeah, but you can't compare GTA stories to The Last of Us and Uncharted.
No.
That's just pure storytelling.
I mean, you're playing
GTA. Exceptional storytelling.
You're playing GTA, you're just fun.
Yeah, you're just killing things.
You just do whatever you want.
It's fun. You're customizing your character. You're going to the gym. You're
doing whatever
going
you
to the
want.
Strip club.
Yeah,
you're
like
going
a
to the bar.
Well,
that's what I liked about San Andreas was that you could actually it had a ton of RPG elements in it.
I think Cody wasn't here.
I know. I saw Telltale.
Telltale.
Telltale guy.
Telltale. I wouldn't even put because Telltale essentially is making the same game every single time.
It's
always an episodic story
driven. And they always don't run.
That's fine.
It's always broken.
But wait till they all come out at once and then it'll run.
I was trying to see because they didn't have the list of games, but Take-Two has done BioShock, Borderlands.
That's a publisher, though.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Not a developer.
Who developed Borderlands?
What?
Who developed Borderlands?
That's Gearbox.
Gearbox.
Go ahead, say they're a hit studio. Battleborn.
Yeah, no.
Battleborn's $15 somewhere right now.
No, it's not.
Yes.
What? Yeah. It bombed that
Overwatch
bad?
Well,
oh, yeah, because it came out same time as Overwatch. Yeah.
I'm going to see, because I saw something from Cheap Ass Gamer the other day. I'm going to look it up. That it was like, I looked at it and I was like, if I could actually sit down and play a game like that, that's really.
Did you get Overwatch yet, Borgon?
No. I've been playing.
Last of Us. I'm going to get it probably this week.
For what, Overwatch?
Yeah.
I see a bunch of people posting about it constantly, though, and it looks super
fun. Yeah, it looks so much like so much fun.
Oh, yeah. $39.99.
I did hear that it was $15, though, on Colin and Greg. Like, they said that it was
definitely $15. Like, it's definitely $40 somewhere, because that even then, for a price drop that quick.
Came out, like, 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, to drop already to $40 is, and I think that was Amazon.
I wouldn't be surprised, actually, if this was Rockstar.
What?
With IGN.
IGN top 50 video gamer.
Oh, I'm glad somebody else has done it, because that's too many game makers to think about.
Infinity Ward.
How old is this?
And number one is Nintendo.
Yeah, yeah. I can see that. Because that's going off of...
Just because they've been around forever and what they did.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, if you're going off
they've
of that...
They've been around since the early 80s.
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, the 1880s.
1880s. If you go to my wiki...
If you're going,
they're coordinating farm games.
Yeah, see, when you start bringing Atari,
yeah, no, yeah. It's not Atari at all. I wouldn't consider Atari a developer. Oh, get the fucking shit. Konami, founded 1969. They were making fucking
69
casino machines. They do have great games. You're looking at Castlevania, Metal Gear, yeah. And Silent Hill.
Phantom Pain was great. It was fun.
But again, they you know.
Yeah, this is going off their whole history. Yeah, yeah. Obviously, there'd be a lot more, like, if you're going off the whole history. I was talking about the modern day game developer.
Right. See, there's Rockstar. And they're
Rockstar North, yeah.
Yeah, same thing. They have all the GTA games. I mean, they're essentially the same type of game.
Well, the same thing goes for Uncharted, though. Yeah,
right,
the
exactly. Same type of game. That's what I was saying.
Yeah, I don't.
But they elevate it each time, and so does Rockstar.
Well, you should improve.
Yeah, no, there are people
you're playing
that just
Madden or something. You know, yeah, you should improve every time. And this was another one that I said was Capcom, but anyways, yeah, no, they definitely have their big hits, and they don't have many. I'm sure they have some early, very early swing and misses. I think with any company, you're going to have that.
Yeah, just not.
But recently, you know, they found their niche, and they're doing well. You know, The Last of Us is probably going to get some sort of spinoff, if not
Last of Us 2.
A sequel.
Yeah.
Can't wait.
Probably what they're working on next.
Yeah.
It's the only reason why I would get a PlayStation
for Last of Us. Yeah.
Did you ever play one?
I watched Dyer play the whole thing.
Yeah, because Dyer can play it by himself.
He always plays with himself.
No, that he's perfectly capable of doing it by himself.
I'll have to get that game.
They made a remastered for it, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. See, if I got a PlayStation, that's what I would do. I would just buy one.
Well, there was a PlayStation
get two.
For...
There was a bundle.
I'm not
with
saying
it.
Now.
You saying should buy it right now. Buy it right now.
There was
right
a deal now. I just saw, but...
Okay. Impulse buy.
Why aren't you buying it?
I'll get you drunk and you'll buy it.
I'm waiting for like a PS4.5 or whatever they're doing.
Yeah, if they do a 4K thing...
Then I'll get it.
Yeah.
I can't wait till they make Xbox One 4K and it's like the size of this room.
They're supposed to be making a new one and it's supposed to be smaller.
Like they said it's also super powerful.
Anything's going to be smaller than that. It's probably the size of the PS4.
How old is this that it's still Squaresoft and not Square Enix?
It's the same thing.
No, I'm just curious when the date on 86. The article.
Oh, no. The article. Oh, yeah. I don't know. I don't even... What the... I mean, that was posted recently, but... I'd have to go to, like, the beginning of the thing. Home.
So...
I'm just curious because I want to see if Naughty Dog
when they were Squaresoft, they had a really lot...
Yeah, they were much better when they were Squaresoft.
I don't know. You can look and see. I don't see a date.
Yeah, I don't see a date either. So not worth it.
So how about that NBA 2K16, 2K17 cover?
Watch your mouth.
Anybody?
Paul George.
Paul George. PG.
From the Pacers.
Man with two names. First name.
Always a crowd pleaser.
Yes, I agree.
It's a pretty good pick.
It got real quiet.
I was like going with Kawhi. I thought Kawhi Leonard should have got it, but, you know, Kawhi Leonard deserves everything.
We doing sports again?
Just saying.
I'm just going to wrap
We started with sports and we ended with sports.
Wrap this neat little gift up with sports.
I mean, bless you. Do you guys want to talk about Game of Thrones?
If you want, we got like 10 minutes.
We can talk Game of Thrones.
What do you guys think?
Spoilers. If you still watch this and complain about spoilers, fuck right off.
Spoilers.
Yeah, if you jump cut to this or whatever, sorry, you just you should be watching the whole thing.
One more time. Spoilers.
All right, so Game of Thrones. What were your thoughts?
I thought it was good. It was obviously
you're talking the latest
like a
episode.
Little, yeah. I want to just talk the latest episode, especially about Benjen.
That was dope.
Yeah, that was pretty awesome.
Yeah,
I don't think it's the character of Cold Hands from the book, but it was pretty cool to see him back and to actually like they took. So there's a character in the book called Cold Hands who. First, he appears to take Sam and Gilly from the north to the wall, and he's literally described as like a ranger. It's the assumption that he's Benjen, but Martin said he's not Benjen. He's supposed to be from like way, he's been dead way longer than Benjen had, but it's the same type of thing. And I think he rides a moose.
A moose?
Or a reindeer, and he gets followed around by a pack of ravens.
It's pretty crazy.
But then he takes Bran, Mira, Hodor, George.
So Hodor never dies in the book?
Hodor is not dead yet. I'm assuming Hodor dies in the book now, especially since it came from Martin. I'm assuming it was always planned for Hodor to die.
Real quick, just to be honest, who gives a fuck?
About Hodor?
Yeah. The fact that became like a fucking bigger death than fucking Robb Stark, all those people can watch that show can go right the fuck.
Yeah. I thought it was so cheese that was... I don't know.
I thought it was good writing, yeah, but like I don't think it has the emotional impact of like
felt sorry for him.
I don't care.
Hang on, well, did you guys see the meme of the cat and Hodor?
Cat and Hodor.
It's let me out, let me out. Hold the door, Hodor. The cat's like, let me out, meow.
That's pretty funny.
I saw that one today.
But yeah, Hodor, that was like an upsetting death, but it was like
not nearly.
It's not like I was attached to Hodor.
Summer like, getting killed was way more of a fucking.
Summer, I just don't like seeing animals get killed. Yeah. Like I'd have to do every fucking week with this show.
Yeah,
it's always it's always like someone's dying.
We don't want to pay for the wolves anymore, so we'll just fucking kill them.
Yeah,
you fucking budget your show better, assholes.
they're not making much. I mean, take it easy.
But I figured something had to happen to fucking save the two of them because they were fucking helpless.
Yeah.
Out there.
They're still helpless.
They're still pretty helpless, yeah.
I do like their storyline though. Like
it's the best storyline.
Yeah, it's really,
I said that to Gio when we were watching it. I was like, I never thought I'd like Bran's storyline.
The best part of his storylines to me is the flashbacks.
Yeah, those are the best parts.
Because they fill in a lot of big holes.
Yeah. Well, I just like that he's basically going to be a god in like four episodes.
Yeah, well, he already is the three-eyed raven. Yeah. Like he's already taken that role.
Talking about this week's episode.
So he's three-eyed raven. He's Doc, Marty McFly, and the DeLorean. Is that what he is? Thank you.
That joke made no sense to me, and I really find it funny.
The three-person raven? Forget it. Whatever. Go for it.
What?
You know, he's going back to the future. He's changing things.
Fuck you, Gio.
Anyways.
I get it,
but fuck you.
You got it, but you didn't laugh, so.
Whatever, because I had to explain it. It was dumb.
Fuck
Whatever.
Off, Dad.
Move on. I'm sorry. I interrupted you for
not really. I kind of interrupted you in the middle of your joke. I kind of wish I did a better job of it now, though. I didn't give a shit about Arya's storyline until last week.
Yeah.
No, yeah. Arya, I feel like that's been coming, especially after last week's episode where when she was like, oh, she seems like a good woman. I was like, good. I could not, when I was reading the books, I couldn't deal with her being a fate. I was like, this isn't Arya. Yeah, she wants revenge and shit, but why is she going to
join? She already has the skills. Why does she have to like throw away everything?
Yeah, she's too much of an
individual.
What's
the point of getting her? Yeah, what's the point of getting revenge if you're not a Stark anymore?
Exactly. Like, that's what she's realizing, and she's realized how individualized she is, and especially I think once she saw like that girl mouthing the lines, she was like, fuck this bitch.
Yeah.
Fuck you. I love that, actually. I was like, oh, she's going to poison her. And I was like, no, she's not. But I love the little throwaway, watch out for this one, and then just leaves. Like, fuck yeah.
Yeah.
And then the fact that she hid Needle away.
Got it back.
Got needle back. So, and then of course the waif goes and rats on her.
Yeah.
Because the waif.
I think she's gonna kill that girl. Oh,
yeah.
Like they're gonna come after her and she's gonna kill
they
her.
Are. Well, the waif's probably gonna get sent after her. Yeah. She's gonna be, I'm assuming next week is gonna be about her trying to find some way back to Westeros.
Yeah.
By the way, this is my bold prediction for the show this season. Jon Snow's gonna die again. He's gonna stay dead. I honestly think that. Like, I think they're
he's gonna be dead dead?
Yeah, like Ramsay's gonna kill him somehow. Like, sneak up behind him.
You think Ramsay's gonna kill him?
Yeah. Not in like a combat. I think he's gonna be a sneaky bastard.
It's gonna be just.
And it's gonna be like, Martin's gonna be like, hey, fuck you guys.
I'm so sick of Ramsay.
Well, that's a dude. That's the ultimate heel move. This solidifies him as the top heel in the company. Stabs Jon Snow.
The Ramsay scenes all just play out the same every single time he's on, and it's just like. I don't care anymore.
My parents got mad at me because when he killed his baby brother,
yeah,
the dogs, they're like, oh my god, that was so horrifying. I'm like, he chopped Theon's dick off.
Yeah.
And they're like, you think that's worse than the baby? I'm like,
he's above killing the baby.
Yes, I do.
No way.
No, when what's her face tried to kill him in his bedroom. I was like, you're going to get stabbed in the throat. You're going to get stabbed in the throat. Oh, you got stabbed in the fucking throat. And ooh, Ramsay's
and then he ate
so
right
evil.
Off the knife.
And then, ooh, look at Ramsay. Is he enough to fuck off?
Once he gets out of that and he goes into a battle, I think it's going to change his
I think Ramsay's going to be dead by the end of the season.
Yeah, I think he's
gonna. Yeah, after he kills Jon.
But he's just going to, he's one of those characters that's not smart enough to live in the, like, to continue on in this.
Right. Here's another
game.
Thing.
He wouldn't be able to play the Game of Thrones.
Here's another thing. I wish Joffrey was back because Tommen's a little bitch.
Yeah.
A little baby back bitch. Who just does whatever the fucking.
Oh, I don't know.
Chasing pussy he's never had.
No, he is a little bitch.
He gets played by fucking everyone.
I think
everyone. Marjorie. You know what, the fucking priest would be dead. 3 weeks to Sunday and fucking Joffrey was still around.
Like, this guy right here? Yeah, kill him.
I don't have time for him.
Everyone in this fucking church right now, dead.
Yeah.
It's that. I think that's Marjorie, I think, is setting that up. Because now
she's really good at the Game of Thrones.
She's playing for Marjorie now, and she doesn't give a fuck about Tommen. She doesn't give a fuck about... Well, she cares about her family, but she knows she's got to play it this way in order to... get what she wants. She's got to get the Sparrow under her control, and he's another one too. He'll be dead soon.
And that dude's a fucking
jack
off.
I hate that guy. Every time I look at him, I just want to punch him.
I like Ramsay more than I like that jack off.
Yeah, me too.
But I think she's pulling the strings on that one. Jaime. So is Jaime's the Lord of Casterly Rock now? I guess.
No, he can't be.
It's the uncle, I think.
Yeah.
He took over.
I mean, isn't he technically Tommen reinstilling his power to him?
No.
Or is he just...
He's just a general. Yeah, he's not... Yeah.
Okay.
It's not like... It's not, he didn't die. So, Jon Snow got the weasel out of the Night Watch because he died and his watch ended. He already had renounced Casterly Rock like 3 separate times.
Right. So. But then he's removed from the Kingsguard. So...
Yeah, but
technically, Tommen can, I guess, reinstate that.
Yeah, but I think like 3 strikes, you're out.
He's reinstated as the Lord of Casterly Rock, I guess. Because, I mean, what's he going to do?
I think he can't really go back
to the Kingsguard, though. I think the uncle's just the hand.
I think he's the Lord, though.
I think the assumption's always been that it's just been run by all of them. Because the uncle, as far as I know, has barely been in Casterly Rock.
Especially
book-wise, he seems to always be there in King's
Landing. Well, now... that Tywin's dead, and obviously it's not gonna go to the Dink.
Yeah.
Because of being part of the Kingsguard, like, I don't think you could go back on it. I think you forsake all titles.
It's too fucking confusing.
Bronn's
back next week, so.
I like Jaime, so I'd like to have him like him to have a face turn, but I think he's gonna get killed by Blackfish.
I like how you put in a lot of wrestling terms.
That's how I view all television.
He's getting Jaime's reuniting with Bronn, which is gonna be fun because they already showed a picture of Bronn and him.
Well, that's because Bronn
at the siege.
Bronn and
are they doing a tag team? Like
basically,
Bronn and Cersei they have real life heat.
Yeah,
and So they don't, they can't be in scenes together. So that's why he's never in the same scenes.
She's not a fan of Ripper Street, I guess.
He probably banged her in his boy band days. That's true. He has a hit single as part of a two-man boy band in England.
But Brienne and Jamie reunited too soon, since she's on her way to River Run.
Oh, that's right.
Which
it all centers around the Blackfish.
So a whole bunch of stuff going back to the Blackfish. Good fucking luck to them in that one, because that siege I don't think is going to go well for them.
The Blackfish or the people sieging
the siege?
Yeah.
The sieges. I don't see it going very well. A siege never.
Walder Frey showing his fucking slimy face again. Hey, should go back Walder to cleaning Frey, after the wizard.
That Walder Frey monologue
muggle.
When he was like, I won't be embarrassed. And I looked at Carson and I went, by these darn wizardy students.
I don't like how creepy he got with like that 14-year-old girl slash
wife. Oh, he kept just grabbing her,
yeah.
grabbing her onto the lap. I was like, yikes.
Yeah, that was great.
Here we go.
That's what happens when you only have a cat as a companion and all those wizards are fucking with you.
You sick freak.
Peeves. All right, I think we're good for this week. Anything you guys would like to plug? Anything that's ever going to show up on YouTube?
I don't know.
Mike's probably deleted it all.
It's all
Mike already deleted this episode.
It's already gone.
Hasn't been recording anyway.
Oh, man.
Like, share, subscribe.
Yeah,
as always.
Thanks for all the views on that last episode. That was cool.
Sweets.
Stop watching this show.
Goodbye.
You know who you are.
Oh, God. I already got
goodbye.
An NBA video update about Steph Curry hitting a three. I don't give a fuck.